Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. Prepare in advance for your interview with the best possible React Native interview questions and answers. In this part, we will review the best questions at the junior level. How is React Native different from ReactJS? ReactJS can be described as a base derivative of React DOM for the web platform, while React Native is a base derivative in itself, which means that the syntax and workflow remain the same, but components alter. ReactJS eventually is a JavaScript library, which enables the programmer to create an engaging and high-performing UI layer, while React Native is an entire framework for building cross-platform apps, be it web, iOS, or Android. In ReactJS, Virtual DOM is used to render browser code in ReactJS, while in React Native, native APIs are used to render components in mobile. The apps developed with ReactJS renders HTML in UI, while React Native uses JSX for rendering UI, which is nothing but JavaScript. CSS is used for creating styling in ReactJS, while a style sheet is used for styling in React Native. What are perops in React Native? Most components can be customized when they are created with different parameters. These created parameters are called perops, short for properties. For example, one basic React Native component is the image. When you create an image, you can use a perop named source to control what image it shows. Your own components can also use props. This lets you make a single component that is used in many different places in your app with a slightly different properties in each place by referring to props in your render function. What are the advantages of native apps over hybrid apps and web apps? Smooth work, fast operating speed, and flawless performance. The native versus hybrid app is built for a specific OS and take full advantage of the processing speed of the device. Great design and user experience possibilities. For instance, the implementation of sophisticated UX UI design and animation. Native app UI allows users to understand navigation within the app more quickly. Good integration with the hardware of the device, e.g. camera, GPS, phone, touchscreen. Easy to launch in the App Store. When it comes to the question of native versus hybrid app or a mobile web app, native applications follow the OS guidelines completely. Better security and reliability. Apps developed natively are checked and approved by the App Store. Easy to implement new sophisticated features that the market demands, AI, VR, AR, IoT, etc. in native versus hybrid app. SDK for developers. It provides half-ready, regularly updated solutions and libraries that interact properly with a given operating system. What happens when you call setState? The first thing React will do when setState is called is merge the object you passed into setState into the current state of the component. This will kick off a process called reconciliation. The end goal of reconciliation is to, in the most efficient way possible, update the UI based on this new state. To do this, React will construct a new tree of React elements, which you can think of as an object representation of your UI. Once it has this tree, in order to figure out how the UI should change in response to the new state, React will diff this new tree against the previous element tree. By doing this, React will then know the exact change will occur, and by knowing exactly what change occurred, will be able to minimize its footprint on the UI by only making updates where absolutely necessary. What is Flux? Flux is an architecture that Facebook uses internally when working with React. It is not a framework or a library. It is simply a new kind of architecture that complements React and the concept of unidirectional data flow. A typical Flux architecture will leverage this dispatcher library, along with Node.js's event emitter module, in order to set up an event system that helps manage an application's state. What is JSX? JSX is an XML, HTML-like syntax used by React that extends ECMAScript, so that XML, HTML-like text can coexist with JavaScript React code. The syntax is intended to be used by preprocessors, i.e. transpilers like Babel, to transform HTML-like text found in JavaScript files into a standard JavaScript objects that a JavaScript engine will parse. For example, the text inside view tag return as JavaScript function to the render function. What is the difference between a state and props? The state is a data structure that starts with the default value when a component mounts. It may be mutated across time, mostly as a result of user events. Props are a component's configuration. They are received from above and immutable as far as the component receiving them is concerned. A component cannot change its props, but it is responsible for putting together the props of its child components. Props do not have to just be data. Callback functions may be passed in as props. What is the point of Redux? Redux is used mostly for application state management. To summarize it, Redux maintains the state of an entire application in a single immutable state tree, which can't be changed directly. When something changes, a new object is created using actions and reducers. When would you use a ScrollView over FlatList or vice versa? If you need to render a list of similar items from an array or the data is very big, use FlatList. If you need to render generic content in a scrollable container and the data is small, use a ScrollView. Explain the use of Flexbox in React Native. To accommodate different screen sizes, React Native offers Flexbox support. To achieve the desired layout, Flexbox offers three main properties: Flex Direction, Justify Content, and Align Items. Flexbox works the same way in React Native as it does in CSS on the web with a few exceptions. The defaults are different, with Flex Direction defaulting to column instead of row, and the Flex parameter only supporting a single number. Well, I hope you have a successful interview. In addition, you can use the React Native tutorial series on the channel to improve your technical skills. In the next part, we will review the higher levels together.